Hello, welcome to a video on how to use the ProLedger software program for truck drivers. And in this video, we're just going to give you the basic overview. And I just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Steve, and I've produced this software. And it would be and thanks for joining me today. So let's take a look at the website first of all. On the ProLedger's website, you're going to notice there's different product pages. And the page I'm right on right now is for truckers. And when you go here, you can scroll down. You're going to notice that there's four different ledger programs that you can choose from. On the left side, we have Canadian trucker ledgers, and there's two of those, the basic and expanded. And on the right side, there's the US trucker ledgers, and there's also two of those, basic and expanded. The differences are that on the Canadian trucker side, you're able to track your input taxes. So if you have an HST, GST, or even PST to track and remit to the government, it allows you to track a couple of sales taxes. And on the US side, we're assuming that you don't need to track sales taxes on revenues or expenses. But if you do, then of course a Canadian trucker ledger would actually work for you in any case. And if you're joining me or from another country with that input tax, such as in Australia or different parts of Europe, you can certainly choose the Canadian version, because really all it's doing is tracking one or two sales taxes, and you're quite able to use it as well. On the each of the ledgers, you're going to notice there's a video button, which is the video you're watching now. And the free trial button. So you have a 30-day free trial. And then anytime during the free trial, you can actually choose to download the program and buy it as well, and then continue to work on your data so you won't lose any data even at the end of the free trial. Now, the other thing to mention here is that the difference between the basic and expanded versions. The expanded version will allow you to track multiple trucks separately. So if you have one truck only to track, or you just want to use one file per truck, then the basic versions will do it. If you have more than one truck to track and you want an income and expense statement for every truck, then the expanded version would be the better version to get. And you can see the prices are highlighted there. That's a one-time fee, so there's no annual or ongoing fees. The other thing I'll mention about the website, and we'll get right into the software right away, is that down at the bottom, you'll see that there's free apps for both Android and for the Mac. So you can download those and use those for free. And they hook through your Dropbox, Google Drive, or OneDrive account. And there's videos on how to set that up, and it's real easy. And then you can actually make entries on the fly, and they also allow you to take pictures of the receipts. And they'll attach themselves to the bookkeeping entry automatically, and everything will sync back to your desktop computer. So, real easy for you to make entries and stay in sync with your computer back home. And that's and there's the videos, like I mentioned, to do that. And there's a few FAQs below that as well. And we also have an FAQ page with lots of helpful videos on different ways to use the ledger, and you can take a look at those on our website. Okay, so let's take a look at the program and see what it can do for you. When you open the software up, you're going to see this opening screen. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn off this camera now that we've talked a bit. I'll get out of the way here. All right, so now we have the opening screen, and on the opening screen, you're going to see three options: current file, new file, and open file. And if you are starting for the first time, you're going to want to use the new file function right here. And so you can then choose, if you have the Canadian version, you'll get this option to choose one or two taxes to track. So I'm going to choose one. And here you have different file types, and we're going to use the trucker file type because it's already set up with some basic chart of accounts, and it'll get you up and running real quick. So let's just click on that file type. And you're going to see the working screen. And on the right side, there's some helpful tips and so on. You can turn that off right there and just clean up the screen if you like a little bit. And here you go. So here's your opening screen. And across the top, you're going to notice all our command buttons. And then we've got filter buttons and so on. We're going to go through that together in this tutorial. And real simple, really, once you get used to it, there's no drop-down menus or anything. So everything is right in front of you. Real simple, nice and clean, no hunting around for stuff. So what we're going to have to do now is, let's say you want to enter a record. right off the hop. Okay, let's say you want to get busy with it. So you hit that green button, but it's saying to you, oh, you have to save the file before you enter any records. So, okay, so you see the file name that it gave you, it's just a default name, but we actually have to save it. So choose save, then choose a location on your computer to save it in. And if you save it inside your OneDrive folder or Google Drive or Dropbox, that would be really great. Then it would sync with your app. But nonetheless, just to keep it simple, I'm just going to save it here on the desktop, and we're going to call it a test file. We can call it whatever you like. You can name it by the year, 2018, you know, bookkeeping file, whatever you want to call it, but we'll just give it something for now. Okay, so here you go. We've given it a name and saved it in a spot on your computer drive. And now we're ready to do entries. And to do entries, you just use that green enter record button and you just follow the prompts. It's that easy. And on the left side, you can see the fields that are mandatory have a red star next to them. And basically, you know, in this case, fill in the date, whatever that is, fill in whatever account is being impacted by the entry. And if it's a payable or receivable, you just choose that there. And but for now, let's say you did a Visa transaction, and let's say it was, was it for general trucking business expense? Was it a personal expense? Now, I should mention that the program will allow you to keep track of all your personal and business expense. If you don't want to keep track of your personal stuff, that's fine. Just don't use the personal class and you'll be all right. The other thing is you'll notice that there's a split class, which means you can take an expense item or an expense transaction and split it between business and personal at any ratio you would like. So for example, you're on the road, you buy a meal and 80% of that is tax deductible and 20% isn't. You can go into the setup screen and we'll show you that a little bit later and set up a ratio for that meal expense at 80-20. And then when you make the entry, choose split and it'll do the math 80-20 for you right off the hop. So anyway, that's just a little feature there. If you have the basic version, you're not going to see truck one, truck two, and so on. Like, this is the expanded version we're looking at. So with the basic version, you'll just get the top three items to choose from in class. Everything will be considered general. But if you have the expanded and you want to track set trucks separately, that's where they're going to show up. And in the setup screen, you can add trucks and you can name them any way you like, or trailers, or even a driver, depending on how you want to produce your income and expense statements. And we'll give you some examples of how this can work. Okay, let's say this is a general business entry, and let's say it's for repair, or let's say, you know, it could be for diesel fuel in this example, and let's say it's $200. And in this case, because we have the Canadian version, it's going to show you different tax options here, and you can just enter in the tax right off the bill. And in the US version, you won't see these tax options, but so then you can also enter it manually if it doesn't quite line up for you. And then the other thing you can do is you can add the receipt using the receipt manager. So if you have this receipt scanned onto your computer drive, you can browse for the PDF and attach it, and it'll just show up on this list. Or if it's a photo of the receipt, you can attach it here. And if you need to take a digital image of it, you can choose that, and the webcam will just turn on and it'll allow you to take a picture of the receipt using the webcam. Now, when you're using the free apps, it also has a receipt manager button to it. And so you can actually, that's real handy, because on the app, on the phone or tablet, when you open this type of screen up, you'll see it on the app, it'll have the same kind of input screen. And on the bottom, it has the receipt manager. It allows you to use your camera phone to take a picture of the receipt and it'll attach itself to the entry. So that'll be something you can see on the app video. It's very convenient. But anyway, once you've got the entry done, choose submit and you're done. So now we've just entered in our diesel fuel expense, and you can see it right there. And the other thing you might want to do in the description field is put in the trip. Let's say it's 221 or whatever, or you want to also put in the vendor name. Let's say it's SO. And then you can keep track of these kinds of things. And we'll show you the advantage of that in a bit. Okay, so here's your record. And in the report screen, you'll see it showing up on the right-hand side. There's a business only summary. And you can see the item that we just entered. On the left side is an overall summary between business, tax, and personal, assuming that there is tax. And you'll see those two reports on an ongoing basis. When you scroll down, There's a tax summary if you're using the Canadian version. There's a reconciliation report. So right now we have an unreconciled item. So when you go back here, if you want to reconcile with your bank statement, and there's a video on how to do reconciliations in our FAQ page, but I'll just mention here that you can just choose that to reconcile by putting an X there. Or if you have foreign currency, you can just choose foreign currency. And when your bank statement comes in, you can update the entry and then choose the X or no receipt. So anyway, when you go back to the report, you can see now it's fully reconciled. That's blank. And down here, you can see how much you've been spending or transferring money between different accounts and how many receivables and payables you have right there. So anyway, that's the basics of that. And then there's a graph here, screen, and you can choose line or column graph. And you can also choose to display just the expenses, or if you want to display net income or just income, you can just check those boxes there. And you can also choose your date filter here. If you want to just see the entries for a certain month or for a certain quarter, then you just choose the filters. And then automatically when you're filtering, the reports and the graphs will update themselves. All right, so that's how you do an entry. And if you want to do an income entry, it's the same thing. You would just choose the date and the account that's affected, and then you could choose a truck number on the expanded version or just general. And let's say it's trucking income, put in the trip ID of some kind. It's kind of handy to do. And let's say it's $1,500 or $1,600, and then you submit. So there you go. So you just continue on making your entries just like that. Now, I'm going to show you a few other capabilities of the program and how you can run reports and so on. And there are other videos in the FAQ page on how to use some of the other features of the program. But before I show you the examples, I just want to point out a couple more things about this screen. So we mentioned on the left side, there's the file name box, and you can open several files at once and just flip between them here as you like. This closes the file. This will tag this file that's open right now as the current file. So the next time you open the program, and I'm going to tag it. So now it's tagged as current file. So next time you open the program up on the opening screen, instead of having to navigate to this file that you're working with right now, you can just choose the current file function. It'll just navigate for you. This is a sync button. Now, this is only to be used if you've made entries from another computer or from another device, such a phone or whatever, and this file has never been closed. So before you start working, just so you know, you have the most up-to-date data, just use sync in that case. But never use it if you haven't got your data saved, because what it's going to do is reload the file. So make sure you save the file, and then you're not going to lose the work that you just did. And only use sync if you've been working on another device and it's been writing data to that file and you just don't see it here on the screen yet. And if you want, you could just close the program and reopen it, and it'd be the same as syncing. Okay, and then here, as I mentioned, are all the filters, and you can filter by month or quarter. You can filter your data by account or by class or by category. And there's also a search box that'll help you filter out the data with any search term that's in your description field. So, and as you can imagine, there's some great potential for reports just on that, and we'll show you some examples. All right, let me just show you a file that has some data in it. So I just made up a file called Trucker Sample, and I'll show you some of the other features about the program here. Now, the one thing I'll mention to you, every column is sortable. At least these columns are sortable, not the total quite as easily, but the other columns are all sortable by clicking on the title. And you notice how I did entries. I put in the trip number, for example, on some entries. And what the nice thing about that is that if you turn on this search box and you type in any partial search match that's in the description field, any identifier, it'll do a report for you. So if I typed in trip number, 121, so I just type 121 and do a search. And here it filtered out all the entries that had 121 into the description field. And you can see all your income and expenses. You can even run a report on that trip, and you can see it on a graph. So that's how easy it is to get reports on trips. And let's try another one. This one's, let's say, trip 126. Oh, now you got trip 126. And because I have the expanded version, I can even see that it's on truck one. And it's that trip on truck one. And here's my report on that particular trip. And here's the graph on it, you know. So anyway, and you can also print this or export it as a PDF or as a spreadsheet file. And whatever you have on your screen is what's going to be produced on your printout or when you export it. So real simple, real handy to run your trucker reports just with that description field on the search box down here. All right, well, that's really all there's to it. And the other thing I was going to mention before you go is let's go to the setup screen. In the setup screen, you can choose your year, the first month of your financial year, your accounts, all your classes are set up here, any taxes, and you can add income categories or change the name of them at any time. And if you're running personal stuff, you can actually put that in there and just don't put the checkbox next to personal items. The ones that are business related, keep them checked. But this way, you know, your personal stuff won't show up on your business financial statement later. Same with the expenses. And as I mentioned in the expense categories, you can actually keep track of the ratios of any splits. So if you're running a car for the business and you're using the car 30% for business, 70, you can change the ratios here. And then when you do your entries and choose the split class, it'll do the math as I mentioned. And if there's no split, then you can just leave it at 100 business if you want. And just don't use the split class on an entry, and this split won't impact the entry at all. So anyway, that's how you do the expenses. And then below that, if you have reoccurring entries, you can put in pre-written descriptions for them. And rather than having typed them out each time, you can actually just choose them off a list. The other thing would be from year to year, it's real easy to set up a new file, because every year it needs a new file. So, but real simple. All you do is once you've got this set up the way you like it, you save it. And then what you can do is you can actually export this data, you know, as a setup file. And let's say this is for the current year. Then we've exported all the setup data in the setup screen. Next year, when we will create a brand new file, then we just go into setup and choose import, and you can actually import that setup screen into the new file without having to re-enter all of this stuff. And then all you do is change the year and you're off, ready to go. So it just takes a couple of minutes. There's a video on that as well, how to set up a new file. And the last thing I'll mention to you is that there's a couple other handy things. I mentioned that, okay, let's say for example, you have a repetitive entry. You can actually just go to the repeat button and just choose the date that the entries occur. And you see how they're showing up on the list. And you can just submit that and it'll just do all the repeating entries as one entry and show up. So that's a real handy thing. And here you see how they all came up there. Now this works especially well if you have a truck payment or you have a bank fee payment or something that's happening on a regular basis, and you can just enter it right up front. And what you could do is also, instead, if it's in advance, if you're setting up these payments at the beginning of the year, you could set them up as receivables or payables. And then each month as the payment is made or the money is received, you can just update the entry to the account that you want, the account that's being affected by that entry. And there's a video on that as well. So anyway, thanks for tuning in. I hope you found this helpful.